Hello, I am Chris Menard. In this video, we're going to talk about one of the most important things you can do in Excel, and that is selecting a range quickly. I'm going to be using the keyboard throughout this video. I may pick up the mouse, but we're going to stick with the keyboard because that is the fastest way to select. Now, this file that I'm using, you can download it for free, and you can follow along with this video for free. The keyboard shortcuts we're going to be focusing on, two main ones, Ctrl and the Shift key, but the other keys we're going to use are the Home key, the End key, and then all four arrow keys. So let's dive in right now. So this very first exercise is really simple. I'm on the worksheet called Keyboard 1. There are no blank cells in this range. I'm just going to go ahead and click with the mouse in A1 in case you didn't know how to get there. I'm also just going to scroll down to show you that this data ends in cell J36. So, the first tip is this. You want to get to the end of your data. Hold down the Ctrl key and press the End key. Ctrl End will take you to the end of your data. I'm in cell J36. Ctrl Home will take you back to A1. So there is Ctrl Home, Ctrl End. Now, if you want to move around the data, I'm in A1 and I want to jump all the way to the far right column. And again, no blanks. Hold down Ctrl and press the right arrow key. I'm still holding down Ctrl, the left arrow key, the down arrow key, the right arrow key, the up arrow key, and the left arrow key. And now I'm going to let go of the Ctrl key. So once I held down Ctrl, I just used the four arrow keys to get around. So now let's talk about selecting. That would be the Shift key. Hold down the Shift key and keep pressing the right arrow key. I don't care how many times you press it. I hope you realize the Shift key and the arrow keys help you select. Go back to cell A1. If you need to click there with the mouse, click there. Hold down the Shift key again now, and now start pressing the down arrow key, and now you're selecting down. Let go of the Shift key, press the up arrow key. You're back in A1. Could have done Ctrl Home also. So Ctrl moves you around, Shift selects. That's why those are the two main ones. Go ahead and just arrow over, you're not holding down Ctrl or Shift, to the source column in column F. Control Shift down arrow. Hold down Control and Shift with your left hand. Press the down arrow key one time and you've selected F1 to F36. And then you could do formatting or conditional formatting or whatever you needed to do to these. If you highlighted numbers, you could go make them accounting or currency or whatever. Press the up arrow key and you're back in F1. One tip before we move on. We know that Ctrl End will take us to the last cell. If you come into your data, and I'm using the mouse now, I'm going to go to cell L38 and I'm going to type my name. Press Enter. Ctrl Home, Ctrl End, let go of the Ctrl key, working. Delete your name or my name, Ctrl Home and Ctrl End again. Notice it's jumping to where the cell is that I deleted. I see this happen all the time. The trick to doing this is to go ahead and save your file. If just saving it alone doesn't do it, you sometimes have to close the file and reopen for Excel to realize that this really ends in J36. I'm going to try just saving. Let's just see if this works for me. You can do Ctrl S to save. Ctrl Home, Ctrl End. It is working for me with just doing a save. I didn't have to close it. Let's go to Keyboard 2. If you want to use the keyboard to jump from one worksheet to the next, you're going to do Ctrl Page Down. Ctrl Page Down will move you to the right on your worksheet. Worksheets, Ctrl Page Up will move you back to the left. So make sure you're on Keyboard 2. Let's do Ctrl Home. Right off the bat, you're going to say, Chris, you didn't tell us the truth. Ctrl Home took me to A2 instead of A1. Why did that happen? Really simple. row one is my header row in this example. And I actually went and have already clicked on row two. Do this with me. Go click row two. Go to the View tab at the top. Freeze panes. And I've already clicked freeze panes. So do an unfreeze. Click one time in your data. I'm going to go to cell E4. Now do Control Home. Now you'll go to A1. So if you freeze panes, Control Home will take you to where you froze your cells. In this example on keyboard 2, I've got two ranges. I've got A1 to cell J19, and then I've got another range over in M1 to N, whatever that is, 4. So when you do Control End, you'll actually go all the way to column N just to prove this. Control End, I'm in N19. That is correct. It is working correctly, by the way. Control Home to get you back to the top. Here is one of my favorite tips when you're dealing with ranges. Move over with the arrows to F1. Column F is great. There are no blanks. So your Control Shift down arrow, which I'm not doing, I'm just telling you, it would select F1 to F19. But really what I want to do is highlight column G. So let's go and try this in G. Move over to G1. We are going to end up having to press the down arrow key 5 times because of the 2 blanks that we have here. Let's give it a shot. Hold down Control and Shift. Don't let go of them. Down arrow once. Notice it didn't select at all. Down arrow the second time. Down arrow the third time. The fourth time. And finally the fifth time. So because of those blanks, it took quite a bit of down arrows to select this range. So I've got a tip for you coming up, so just be careful with blanks. And if you had 20,000 cells to select and you got blanks all over the place in that column, it could take you forever to select them. Here's the tip. I moved over to F1. Control, Shift, down arrow. Now, just Shift and the right arrow key. So I have F1 to cell G19 selected. The active cell is F1, so press the Tab key once. You still have it selected, but G1 is active. Now, what you're going to do is Shift and the right arrow key, because column F is selected, so Shift, right arrow, and now you've quickly selected G1 to G19 without all those numerous down arrow keys. I'm going to repeat that. I don't usually repeat stuff in videos, but this is worth doing, and I'm going to do it fast this time. Go to F1 because I know I don't have any blanks. Control, Shift, down arrow. Let go of Control, Shift, and right arrow. Press the Tab key. Shift, right arrow. Done. If you had the 20,000 cells with the blanks in them, that's going to save you a ton of time, by the way. One more tip for you. Control Home. You didn't have to do Control Home. I can be anywhere inside my range. Control A will select the range you're in. Give that one a shot. Control A, that will quickly select the range you're in. Maybe you want to copy it and put it on another worksheet to do some analysis. Let's keep moving. I'm going to move over to keyboard 3. Just to move us along, I've got this range here, and I got a range over in column M. I'm going to go ahead and make this a table. Let's talk about selecting with a table. Click in your data. Control T will convert the current range to a table. A1 to J19, my table has headers. That is correct. Hit OK. I love tables. When you create a table, it'll read table design up in the ribbon. If you don't like the table style you have, you can easily change it. Multiple styles to pick from. Just to keep this simple, I'm actually going to pick this one in the very, very top left corner. Still a table, by the way, because it reads table design. So now when you have a table, I'm going to use the mouse. I know we're talking about the keyboard here. If I want to select this source column that has blanks, if I put my mouse right below column F, the arrow's pointing down, and click, I just selected that range right there. So that's why a table is easier to select. And you're going to say, well, Chris, can you use the keyboard? Sure. Click in column F anywhere you want to. Control space bar is how you select it. Control space bar selected. F2 to F19. It did not pick up F1, which is the header row source. If you want to pick up source, you do control space bar a second time. Now it has source. So that is how you select in a table. If you want to highlight a row, I'm just going to press the down arrow key. I'm in cell F2. I want to highlight row 2. It is going to be shift space bar that selected that range there. So tables, really easy to select your data in. One more tip for you. If I need to select cell F, I'm going to go back to keyboard 2. If I need to select cell G1 and act like the data runs for 95,000 rows and G95,000 is where I need to get to. That's my example. A keyboard shortcut that I love is I'm in G1, Control G. Control G pulls up the go to box. I want to select to cell G95,000 or whatever I said, but in my example, it's going to be G19. If you recall, the shift key selects. Hold down the shift key and press enter, and you select it from cell G1 to G, wherever you want to select to. So control G pulls up go to. You can also do the F5 function key to get go to. If you are a mouse person on the home tab, find and select go to right here. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is part of my Excel online training class. It is based on essentials, intermediate, and advanced, and then I bundled them all together to save you some money. We update those classes all the time because Excel is always rolling out new features, or I'm coming up with a new video. I also have Teams training available online, over 3 hours of material, including all the new Teams stuff, and Copilot and OneNote. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe if you like the video and give me a thumbs up. Have a wonderful day.